We have with us Mr. Keshav Suri, the Executive Director of the Lalit Suri Hospitality Group. Welcome to 10 Years, sir.
Thank you.
So first of all, I'd like to ask you that the hospitality and the tourism industry, it has suffered a rough patch in the last 2 years due to the COVID outbreak. But it appears that it has been, coming back on its feet, because recently in the month of June, there has been a 158% hike in the hiring and the recruitment of new people. So sir, do you think it will be able to keep up with this gaining momentum?
Absolutely. Absolutely. I think that the last 2.5 years have been really tragic for the hospitality industry, even the travel and tourism industry. It has sort of pushed us back to 2018 or even 2017. Having said that, the recovery has been really fast. And the first quarter, I have to say, has almost been like a historic quarter for the hospitality industry, where most hotel chains have sort of bounced back and almost reached the pre-pandemic numbers. In fact, even more. Some have even crossed the pre-pandemic numbers and gone to what they were if 2018 was their highest year. I must say, even for us, our quarter one has been really amazing.
Congratulations.
Having said that, let's not forget that those 2 years have caused so much of destruction that it will still take a little bit of time for us to be fully on our feet again. There was a pent-up frustration, there was a pent-up revenge buying and revenge thing with people, so that is why maybe the spike went up for the first quarter. Also, domestic travel was only the option. Now international travel is being allowed again, right? So we're losing a little bit of our domestic tourists to international countries. But I must say that I'm very proud to be a part of a company that has always focused on domestic tourism and our domestic tourists. So I think that our focus has been singular on them. And I know for a fact that even the next quarter is going to be better. I'm hoping that 2022 is actually a historic year for the hospitality industry. We have to live on hope.
Definitely.
Because what has happened to us should never happen again. It is hopefully just a once in a lifetime experience and never happens again. And whoever has managed to survive like us knows that we can, through the hardest of times, can survive.
And I think, sir, this is the best part of, facing these challenging times, because then we'll be ready with, another challenge that comes our way like this, yes. And so moving on, can you tell us some of the new trends and technology that has been introduced in the hospitality sector, and how is the Lalit Hospitality Group leveraging them?
So I think that clearly it's the age of content. And it's the age of Wi-Fi and it's the age of technology. The hospitality world was slightly behind the rest of the industries in terms of technology, but now we know that we cannot escape it. One of the things that we pivoted very quickly to was having our home delivery app, and to basically get our restaurants to be able to home deliver. So it's a part of our Lalit food truck company. That is one of the things that we immediately had to do. Of course, our website has to be dynamic, and a lot of hotel chains, including us, are getting into the app sphere.
Yes.
Where we're going to expect our team, so that we don't have contact. We have to try and do as much as contactlessness as possible in terms of check-in, check-out. But let's not forget, the ethos of hospitality is the human connect.
Yes.
Right? And for me, the warmth of a human namaskar goes much longer than any app or, AI or robots can do. So whilst we have to embrace technology and we have to move on with it and we have to have great internet speed and we have to be visible on all sorts of platforms, nothing replaces the human connect and the warmth that the Indian hospitality in particular gives.
Very true and very inspiring also, because what I truly believe what you just said, sir, because the warmth and the feeling of namaskar, face-to-face interaction is much more than virtual interaction, and I think we all have learned that in the past 2 years. And so lastly, I would like to ask you that the India Expo Mart recently has announced that it will be organizing the India International Hospitality Expo 2022 in Greater Noida, right, in the month of August.
Yes.
So how influential do you think it will be towards the growth of the hospitality sector And what are your expectations from them, since you are also, the Lalit group is also an enthusiastic participant?
So I am so happy that these marts and the expos are coming back. Yes. We need this desperately. India is probably one of the most fascinating countries in the world. And now with tourism and international tourism also opening up, the world needs to know how fascinating we are. Beyond that, nothing beats the Indian hospitality. Sorry, but you know, other countries like Thailand and all that, they can talk about it, but sorry, nothing beats the warmth, the inclusion and the diversity of Indian hospitality. And that is what I'm expecting from this expo for the world to see.
Yes.
And that's why it's very important for us to make this happen and to keep this going. We need more expos, we need more for hospitality, we need more for tourism, and we need India to be on the global map, which it already is.
Yes.
But to be taken as a serious tourist destination on the global map, that's what we need.
Definitely, sir, because India is definitely the fastest growing economy in the world. And
exactly.
I think it is also coming in the, you know, coming on the global map in terms
yes.
of tourism and hospitality as well.
Yes.
Definitely. And thank you so much for talking to 10
thank
News,
you.
Sir. I'm Shelly Agarwal, and you're watching 10 News.